Today on the bench, a little bit of a fun unboxing of my Signal Corps US Army Tool Equipment TE-50B by the Nanasi Company Incorporated. If you follow the channel, you know that we restored this Navy Teletype from 1940, which was deep into Pile of Rust territory. It was quite an adventure. It involved stripping it to the bone, bathing it in a Teletype aquarium, disassembling it entirely, lots and lots of cleaning, adjusting stuff, adjusting more stuff, reassembling stuff, more reassembling, making confetti, printing encrypted messages, sandblasting rust away, doing just a bit of rewiring, work with beautiful tubes and deadly voltages, making a few finishing touches, and voila, she's all pretty and functional again, ready for intergalactic transmissions. Link to the epic series in the doodly-doo. But how did Mr. RTTY maintain his machines when he was in the army, particularly when it is full of unusual hardware? A true Teletype technician must have needed special tool for his trade. And that's what I finally got today, the one and only TE-50B US Army Teletype Maintenance Toolkit. And this one apparently has not been opened. We're the first ones. It has a copy of the equipment list. Actually, I should scan. I couldn't find this anywhere. So let me take a good picture of that first. I'll be back with you. Okay, I'm back. It's been scanned. It has a flappy flap. Woohoo! All right, so what do we have? In the corner over here, those are gauges. Anything that's mechanical. Oh, that's really awesome. You have three of the round ones and one of the flat ones. 6 mils on this one. And on this one, 2 mils. And it goes up to 80 mils. Very, very, very nice. And I didn't notice, but each pocket has a different width to accommodate the right tool. All right, in the other corner, and those are little wrenches. So wrench socket, wrench open end, pin straight. Why would you have a set of pins and they are the same pins? All right, so I put them back in the right place. Now down here, what do we have? Those would be other wrenches. Ooh. This is a burnishing tool. That's super helpful. That's for relay contacts. When they don't make good contacts, you put that in between. This is a very, very slightly abrasive. Carborandum. A pin? Tapered thing. Two of them. What do they call that? A Tommy wrench. What the heck is that? Ah, okay. So that's a Tommy wrench. You insert it in a hole and you turn like this, provide you with some leverage, because there are two of them. So this must be the thickness gauge, and this must be the alignment tool. All very useful things that I wouldn't have thought to put in my toolbox. Ooh. Is it an oiler? A brush. What I think is an oiler, more of a rake. Spring hook. So they say spring hook pull, spring hook push. So that's to push a spring. Stick, contact file, dental mirror. That is indeed an oiler. I should have a brush and a ruler. What? I don't have a ruler. I've been bamboozled. There's no ruler, or it's been put somewhere else. Okay, good. Let's see if I can remove the protection from the mirror. Man, the stuff is sticky. Even with isopropanol, it doesn't go away. So the thing has undergone some chemical transformation somehow.
No, I was able to save it more or less. And actually, this is not only a mirror, this is a magnifier. It has some curve to it. Very nice. And here there's supposed to be a gear puller. And here another screwdriver for a socket screwdriver. Two of them. Oh, a super duper screwdriver. Oh, that's a good one. There we go. So that's a screwdriver that can hold its screw and is very, very long. So you can fish the screws at the bottom of your teletype. Make everything clean. Probably horsehair, actually. Ooh, this one is very long, and those are very fine. So that's another problem that we had with teletypes, is that the screws, they are much finer than my screwdrivers could go into. And these ones are, I see, are super extra fine. These are to be used for teletypes only, or they probably mar other screws. The set of gauges. For the spring gauges, which I already have used to repair my pen plotters. It's used to tension the belt, which I can do now thanks to my teletype tensioner. A little bit over one when this touches. Whoop. I readjusted all the tensions, actually they were completely off, so this is much better now. It just stops on its own. Alright, it slips when it should and doesn't slip when it should not. Repaired! This one is 4 pounds, 12 pounds, 2 pounds, 8 ounces. That definitely saved me for my pen plotter. We have some Imperial Flint Paper, 3M Company, Minnesota Metal Mining, still with us today, an emery cloth. Same grit, which they call 3 over 0. The Carbon Company Niagara Falls. By the way, in the same pocket, I found my missing ruler. Maybe I also have the puller somewhere, it just fell out. Let me clean that beautiful ruler. It's actually super finely engraved. Union Tool Company in Orange, Massachusetts. Nicely done. And on the top there, that's the most fascinating. These are to calibrate the rotation speed of teletypes, and we'll have to do it one day. And we are done with the top drawer. That's one of the most beautiful voltmeters I have seen. Is it. Ta-da! Signal core multimeter TS297U from Weston Electric. Those used to make the good telephone gauges. It has ohm, so there's a battery in there. Look at that! Wire wound resistors or something like that, precision resistors. And then, yeah, because you got the schematics here, tell you how it's done. It's a good old regular battery, I think. Maybe. It fits. So they are definitely not the regular banana plugs. This is also a test lead, but so you can plug it in straight into a teletype. Ohms. Ooh, nicely damped. And I'm sure you wonder how good it is. One, two, three, four, five. No, it's good. Six, seven, eight, nine, and then 10. If I put it on the 4 scale, it's going to be easier to read. One, two, three, four. Okay, good meter. Excellent. Biggie soldering iron. Oh my goodness. You hook that up to the battery of your Jeep or your tank And you have an iron soldering 110 volts. This is just ginormous. It's 4060, so it's lead tin 4060. Better clean my hands after that. Look at that monster diameter here. This is for big, big, big solder joints. More wrenches. Very cute. I never seen one with the angle like this, but that's very handy. A set of, so those are hex wrenches, but with kind of a super long neck. Those are all interesting tools. Ew! I don't know how you call that one, but that's for special nuts. What the heck? Adjustment thingy? It's a bender of some kind, maybe? More of those beautiful wrenches. They are very thin, so they're really useful specialized tools. Oh! Measuring tape. To make your Teletype advance manually, left threaded. Oh, that's probably a good tool to have for the Teletype. Oh, a very cute screwdriver that you can have screws that are really under something. That's pretty neat. You hold a screw and then you screw it in. So it's a screw holder and a screwdriver. The end is actually a screwdriver. Right, so it goes like this and it just holds your screw in place. Pretty cool. Bell seal bond paper substance 20. Feels like cigarette paper. So that's to make a little, very small shim of some kind. A bag of desiccant. Class 1 desiccant approved under military spec, which actually is probably why this box is in such good shape. Henry Cheney Hammer Corporation, established 1836. This hammer is forged from tool steel and is guaranteed against defect. And that's the little oiler needle. You put it like this, and you can do a calibrated squirt of something. So that's for adjusting eccentrics. Or is it a magnet? Oh, it's magnetic. It's a very weak magnet. So you can pick up your screws. So that's a screw picker. A good knife. Okay, always useful. Tape. Oh, it's still very sticky. Cloth tape. Oh man, it smells like 1930. It's kind of tar tape, maybe. Wrench. Ta-da! Ooh, sticky, sticky, sticky. And so unfortunately, this is probably an imperial wrench. I cannot do metric screws with that one. Oh man, it's all stuck. Yeah, in oil paper, so they wouldn't rust. That's pliers. Wow, completely stuck. Yeah, it's a greaser. Okay, so these need to be clean and brought to hand tool rescue. Oh, files, more files. Gee. A round, a flat. Bleached cheesecloth. Oh, very neat. Oh, excellent. There's a manual for the multimeter. Two of them. Definitely, I need to scan that one. When I looked the multimeter up, I didn't see any of this coming up. Well, guys, that's it. That was our box of military Teletype tools. I am going to use it after I clean all the tools. Oh, they clean pretty good. So it's just the oil that has congealed, but it has done its job. It has protected the metal. I was able to get the adjustable wrench unstuck. So now it's going to do both inch and metric.